Hello friends, earlier we have discussed about some definitions related with this chapter and also we have discussed about the sign convention for this chapter and the sign convention which is most important for this chapter that already we have discussed for the concave mirror and convex mirror that remember friends. Now today we are going to discuss about the relation between the radius of curvature and focal length for the curved mirror, we can say spherical mirror also. This will be same for the concave and convex. Whatever we will derive here, it is same for both type of mirror. Usually, we will derive the equation using concave mirror. This relation also right for the convex mirror also. Now, then today we are going to discuss about the relation between focal length and radius of curvature for the curved mirror. Then see the diagram. The diagram is given for the concave mirror. And some parallel ray is incident on the point M on the concave mirror and it will be reflected from the concave mirror and it will be passed through the focus, principal focus of concave mirror, which is shown by the red ink. Now, the distance between C and P is R and the distance between F and P, it's called F, focal length. Then, now, we have to derive the relation between R and F. Then again see the diagram. Then we know that whatever the angle of incident and angle of reflection, it is always with the normal. And the remember friends, for the concave mirror, whenever we draw the line connecting between any point on the concave mirror and center of curvature of the mirror, it's called its normal. Then the incident ray make angle theta with the normal and we know that the laws of reflection. That's why the reflected ray also makes angle theta with the normal. Now see the diagram very carefully. Then at C it is also angle theta and F it will be 2 theta. Now from the figure we can say that when we draw the perpendicular line MD on the principal axis of concave mirror, then we can get two triangles. One we can say MDC and another triangle is MDF. Now, for the triangle MDC, we can use the tan function, then tan theta is equal to MD upon CD. The similarly for the triangle MDF, use tan function. That's why tan 2 theta is equal to MD upon FD. Now, already we have discussed about the paraxial rays. The paraxial rays means the rays which are very close to the principal axis. Whenever the rays are very close to the principal axis, then theta becomes very small. That's why for the small angle, the tan theta approximate theta and tan 2 theta approximate 2 theta. Therefore, from equation 1 and 2, we can say theta is equal to MD upon CD and 2 theta is equal to MD upon FD. Now, let's check it. For the distance CD and FD, for the paraxial rays, the distance between P and D is very small. So we can say D is similar, yeah, equivalent to P. Therefore, we can say MD upon CD is equal to MD upon 2FD. Therefore,
CD is equal to the radius of curvature and FD is equal to the focal length. Then 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon 2F. That's why R is equal to 2F. Otherwise, F is equal to R by 2. Therefore, either for the concave mirror or convex mirror, we can say focal length is half of the radius of curvature. Otherwise, the radius of curvature is double of its focal length. Now, we will discuss about some another equation. We can say mirror equation. This question will be asked by two ways. One way we can say derive the mirror equation. Otherwise, another way we can say derive the relation between object distance u, image distance v, and focal length f. That is 1 upon f is equal to 1 upon u plus 1 upon v for the curved mirror. So this is the mirror equation. Otherwise, we can say relation between object distance, image distance, and focal length. To derive this equation, see the figure carefully. One linear object AB is placed on the principal axis of concave mirror. This equation also valid for convex mirror also. But for the easy, always we will use concave mirror to derive all equations. Therefore, the object, linear object AB, is placed perpendicularly on the axis of concave mirror. To form the image of this linear object, minimum two rays are required. Here, three rays are indicating, which is originating from the point A. One, which is parallel to the principal axis, it will be reflected and pass through the principal focus of concave mirror. Another ray, which is incident at pole by making angle theta with principal axis, that's why it will be reflected by making angle same theta with principal axis. And third ray, which is passed through the center of curvature. As we know, whenever ray is passed center of curvature, then reflected ray is also passed through the center of curvature. It means whenever the incident ray passes through the center of curvature, it will be reflected on the same line. All three rays are meeting at point A dash. That's why we can say the image of A is formed at A dash. When we draw the perpendicular line on the principal axis from A dash, we can say A dash B dash is the image of AB. Now see the figure carefully. The distance between F and P is called its focal length F. Distance between A dash and P is called its image distance. And distance between B and P is called its object distance. Now, from the diagram, we can see two triangles. One triangle is A dash B dash F, and another triangle is MPF. For the paraxial ray, we can say MP is perpendicularly to the principal axis CP. Once again, for the paraxial ray, the MP becomes perpendicularly to the principal axis. Otherwise, we can say CP. Now, once again, see the two triangles carefully. One triangle A'B'F and another triangle, right angle triangle MPF. These two are similar triangles. Now, therefore, for the condition for the similar triangle, we can say A'B'F is equal to MP upon FP. Samajh mein aa raha hai friends? Once again, for the similar triangles, या फिर कंडीशन फॉर द सिमिलर ट्राइंगल्स. वी कैन से ए डैश बी डैश अपॉन बी डैश एफ इज इक्वल टू एम पी अपॉन एफ पी. वेन वी इंटरचेंज देन वी कैन से ए डैश बी डैश अपॉन एम पी इज इक्वल टू बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी. डायग्राम में से अच्छी तरह से समझ लो फ्रेंड्स कि सिमिलर ट्राइंगल्स की वजह से हमें एक इक्वेशन मिलेगा ए डैश बी डैश अपॉन एम पी इज इक्वल टू बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी. वंस अगेन फ्रॉम ट्राइंगल वी कैन से एम पी इज इक्वल टू ए बी. दैट्स वाई वेन वी रिप्लेस सो वी कैन से ए डैश बी डैश अपॉन ए बी इज इक्वल टू बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी से एज इक्वेशन वन. नाउ वंस अगेन फ्रॉम द ट्राइंगल सॉरी वंस अगेन फ्रॉम द फिगर वी कैन गेट अनदर ट्रू ट्राइंगल्स वन एज ए बी पी एंड अनदर एज ए डैश बी डैश पी. वंस अगेन देखो फ्रेंड्स इन डायग्राम टू ट्राइंगल्स राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल्स वन ए बी पी एंड अनदर ए डैश बी डैश पी. दीज आर ऑल्सो सिमिलर ट्राइंगल्स. देन वेन वी यूज द कंडीशन फॉर द सिमिलर ट्राइंगल्स वी कैन से देयर साइड्स रेशियो आर सेम. देयरफॉर वी कैन से ए डैश बी डैश अपॉन बी डैश पी इज इक्वल टू ए बी अपॉन बी पी. हियर ऑल्सो वेन वी इंटरचेंज द टर्म्स देन वी कैन से ए डैश बी डैश अपॉन ए बी इज इक्वल टू बी डैश पी अपॉन बी पी. नाउ फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन एंड टू द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड्स आर सेम. देयरफॉर कंपेयरिंग इक्वेशन वन एंड टू वी कैन गेट बी डैश एफ अपॉन एफ पी इज इक्वल टू बी डैश पी अपॉन बी पी. हियर What about बी डैश एफ. डायग्राम में ध्यान से देखो फ्रेंड्स हमें चाहिए डिस्टेंस बी डैश एफ. जो बी डैश एफ है वो हमें डायग्राम में से कैसे मिले. देन इट इज़ वेरी क्लियर द बी डैश एफ इज इक्वल टू बी डैश पी माइनस एफ ई एफ पी. बिकॉज बी डैश पी is V and FP is F. That's why V minus F करे तो हमें मिल जाएगा B dash F. Therefore, the B dash F is equal to B dash P minus FP. अगर earlier equation में हम रख दे तो हमें एक equation मिलेगी कि B dash P minus FP upon FP is equal to B dash P upon BP. Now, from figure B dash P, we can say image distance according to sign convention it is minus V. FP is focal length according to the sign convention is minus F. BP is object distance according to the sign convention is minus U. अगर equation में हम substitute कर दे और देखते जाए लिखते जाए तो हमें equation मिलेगी V minus F upon F is equal to V minus U. जो डिनोमिनेटर में F है उसको हम अलग अलग रख दे मतलब एक एक के नीचे रख दे तो मिलेगा हमें V minus V upon F minus 1 is equal to V upon U. अब ये इक्वेशन को मतलब लेफ्ट हैंड साइड राइट हैंड साइड को हम V से डिवाइड कर देंगे मतलब अब वो इक्वेशन इज डिवाइडेड विथ वी. देन वी कैन से वन अपॉन एफ माइनस वन अपॉन वी इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन यू. देयरफॉर मिरर इक्वेशन इज कॉल्ड वन अपॉन एफ इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन वी प्लस वन अपॉन यू. दिस इज कॉल्ड मिरर इक्वेशन एंड इट विल बी एप्लीकेबल फॉर बोथ टाइप ऑफ. सो फ्रेंड्स इट इज कॉल्ड मिरर इक्वेशन 1 upon f is equal to 1 upon v plus 1 upon u. It will be applicable for both type of mirror, either concave or convex mirror. Now our interest to derive one more equation for the magnification. For the magnification, see the diagram. The same diagram, whatever we have discussed earlier, one linear object AB, we can say of height h, is placed perpendicularly to the principal axis of concave mirror N. To form image, minimum two rays are required. One is parallel, obviously it is reflected from the concave mirror and pass through the principal focus. And another ray, which is incident at pole by making angle theta, it will be reflected by making angle theta and cross at point A dash. And when we draw the perpendicular line, then it is called LSB dash is image of height H dash. A dash, yeah, B dash C, it's called image distance, and B se P is called object distance. Now our interest would be the magnification of the mirror. Then what is called magnification? The ratio of height of image and height of object, it's called magnification. Therefore M is equal to H dash upon H. Say as equation 1. Now in diagram, two triangles, right angle triangles, one ABP and another AB'P. They are similar triangles. For the condition for the similar triangles, we can say AB' upon B'P is equal to AB upon BP. Now, use the sign convention and place all values. Means AB' is height of image. Using sign convention, which is below the principal axis, that's why it is minus h dash. B dash p is image distance, means minus v. AB, height of object above the principal axis, that's why positive h. And b to p, it's called object distance, is minus u. Therefore minus h dash upon h is equal to minus v upon minus u. Therefore, h dash upon h is equal to minus v by u. Therefore, equation for the magnification, m is equal to minus v by u, which will be applicable for both type of mirror, either concave or convex. Dono mirror ke liye hum equation use karenge. Magnification m is equal to minus v by u. Now, some other equations for the magnification. Ye relation hua magnification in terms of image distance and object distance. एक हमारे पास equation है for the height of image and height of object से related, that is h dash upon h. Now two more equations for the magnification in terms of focal length and object distance, another in terms of focal length and image distance. Therefore once again, use the mirror equation 1 upon f is equal to 1 upon v plus 1 upon u. If our interest to derive the equation in terms of u, then make subject v. Therefore, 1 upon v is equal to 1 upon f minus 1 upon u. Therefore, 1 upon v is equal to, agar hum LCM le, so v minus f upon, sorry, u minus f upon uf. Agar u ko right hand side le jai, that's why u upon v is equal to u minus f upon f. Inverse kar do, reciprocal kar do, v by u is equal to f upon u minus f. But magnification ki formula hai minus v by u, that's why agar negative sign hum right hand side mein denominator mein de de, that's why magnification m is equal to f upon f minus u. Then this is the third equation for the magnification for mirror. M is equal to f upon f minus u. Now one more equation in terms of image distance. So make subject object distance, 1 upon u is equal to 1 upon f minus 1 upon v. So 1 upon u is equal to LCM le, to v minus f upon vf. Agar v ko interchange kar de, to v upon u is equal to v minus f upon f. But magnification ki formula hai minus v upon u. Therefore, अगर negative sign हम न्यूमिनेटर में दे दे, देन m इज इक्वल टू f माइनस v अपॉन f। तो याद रखो फ्रेंड्स कि मैग्निफिकेशन की एक फॉर्मूला h डैश अपॉन h, अनदर इक्वेशन m इज इक्वल टू माइनस v बाई u, थर्ड इक्वेशन m इज इक्वल टू f बाई f माइनस u, एंड फोर्थ इक्वेशन फॉर द मैग्निफिकेशन f माइनस v अपॉन f। ये जो भी इक्वेशंस है वो बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट इक्वेशन है जो MCQ के लिए भी एप्लीकेबल होगी, या फिर कोई भी हमें न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व करने हैं जिसमें हमें सिर्फ फोकल लेंथ एंड ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस दे रखा है और आस्क अबाउट द मैग्नीफिकेशन, तो यूज़ करेंगे m इज इक्वल टू f बाई f माइनस u। अगर हमें इमेज डिस्टेंस के टर्म्स में दे रखा है देन वी विल यूज़ द इक्वेशन फॉर द मैग्नीफिकेशन f माइनस v अपॉन f। बाकी तो हमारे पास दो इक्वेशन तो है, m इज इक्वल टू माइनस v बाई u जिसमें इमेज डिस्टेंस ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस दोनों दिया है तब, और हाइट के टर्म्स में है देन m इज इक्वल टू h डैश अपॉन h।